Now, Mr. Manjeet Kumar Yadav, All India Rank 239, will be giving a final piece of advice for the next 35 days for people who are giving preliminary examination this year on October 4th. Just a piece of a word of revision or advice which you would like to suggest, sir, to the aspirants who are giving in the next 35 days their prelims.
I'll say 3-4 things. One is that you revise your syllabus 2-3 times before the actual examination. And in last 10 days, at least you should go through the syllabus, entire syllabus, what you read once at least, so that you're able to recall whatever you read in the examination. Another thing is that you practice, say, 10 to 15 question papers in these, around 10 question papers in this next 35 days. Another thing, what I'll suggest is that you also take out time to go through last 2-3 years UPSC question paper. And one can also go through a CDS question paper of last examination. What they will be helpful in is that you'll get the language and the nature of options UPSC itself is making, because the coaching institutes, however, they have adapted to a large extent to the UPSC pattern of question framing, but it's always good to refer once in a while to the original source itself. Another thing is that whatever schemes related things which have whatever the schemes which have come in last 1 or 2 years, you go read through them and don't try to memorize everything, because actually you will not be able to memorize. But at least 2-3 readings you should do that. If a statement comes in the prelims examination, you are at least familiar with those things and you are able to declare it a right or wrong statement. Another aspect is that focus on the science and technology topics. What I used to do is that jot down whatever science and technology topics are in news or whatever topics one encounters in the prelims test series or in current affairs. Say 30-35 topics you will jot down, for example, artificial intelligence, machine learning, or gene therapy, or whatever topics. And then you just Google it and read for, say, half a page or 2 paragraphs on that topic. So just to get the awareness. And plus, additionally, in your question paper solution also, you'll get a lot of information about that. Again, you don't go for memorizing those things, because just read 2 or 3 times. Because the thing is that whatever options, statements will come for a difficult topic, generally UPSC makes it that those statements itself are relatively easier. For a difficult topic, statements itself are relatively easier. If you've read it once, you will be in a position to at least think or guess about something. And last but not the least, that you have to figure out that how many number of questions you have going to attempt. For example, that will depend on your accuracy percentage. So in next whatever 5-10 question papers you are writing, you should figure out what is the accuracy percentage you have. For example, I had around 70% of accuracy percent. So I knew that if my attempt, and this actually accuracy percent will depend on a difficult as well as easier exam. Depends on the, if the question paper is difficult or easy. So in a difficult question paper, I was knowing that in a difficult question paper, if I'm attempting around 85 questions, and an easier paper, I'm attempting around 90 question papers, I'll be able to get 65 to 67 questions correct. And that will be enough to qualify the prelims. So that idea you should have, and actually final call you have to take in the examination center itself. But a little bit of awareness about your accuracy percent will be very much helpful. And last but not least, do not bother too much about it. It's you should enjoy every aspect of this journey. And result is only a part of it. For my personally, my case also, I didn't get down too much. I did not take too much pressure of the examination part itself. This may be because in my life, from 11, 12, the JEE exam, I've given a lot of examination. So I actually used to that pressurized situation. So you have to make yourself comfortable, and so that you are in position to respond properly to the questions, and you are at your best in those 2 hours of time. So these are the few things I'll share, and I'll wish all the best to all the aspirants who are appearing on 4th October this year.